Shri Narendra Modi ji, Honorable Prime Minister of India, Dr. Jitendra Singh, Honorable Minister of State for Personnel, Shri Rajiv and Dr. Bhaseen, my colleagues from the Commission, Dr. P.K. Mishra, Additional Principal Secretary to PM, Shri P.K. Sinhaji, Cabinet Secretary, distinguished guests from government, public sector, public walks of life, ex-VCs and Chief Vigilance Commissioners, ladies and gentlemen, children and media persons. Sir, it's a matter of pride for the Commission that you are a part of this function to validate the observance of the Vigilance Awareness Week 2016. The presence of the Honorable Prime Minister not only clearly indicates the importance the government and Shri Modi ji personally attach to the need to promote integrity and eradicate corruption, but also inspires the vigilance community and all the stakeholders to enhance their efforts in this regard multifold. Sir, we are grateful to you for all your affirmation and look forward to your continued guidance, support and encouragement. Sir, with a view to promote integrity, transparency and accountability in public life, the Commission initiated the practice of observance of Vigilance Awareness Week in the year 2000, the week in which 31st October, the birthday of Bharat Ratna Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, the most shining example of probity in public life, falls, is celebrated as a Vigilance Awareness Week. Corruption is a known serious impediment to growth and development. Economists have postulated that corruption is the antithesis of a free, fair, competitive and efficient market. It distorts objectivity, transparency and fair play that forms the touchstone of the market economy. Over the years, the institutional and legal frameworks for dealing with corruption have been strengthened. These efforts have so far focused primarily on the enforcement aimed at punishing the guilty, expecting to have a serious deterrent effect on others. These do not appear to have fully achieved the desired object. There could be several reasons for this, such as absence or inadequacy of mechanism to detect misconduct as they occur, inadequacies in investigation, drafting, knowledge of law, unwillingness of witnesses to depose, cumbersome laws and procedures, delays in trial, at times lack of integrity even on the part of the investigators and others who are dealing with the cases. Thus, so far anti-corruption efforts were mostly focused on the demand side of corruption. Sir, the Commission therefore turned its focus on Vigilance Awareness Week in 2015 on preventive vigilance as a tool for good governance. To promote transparency and good governance, the Commission through its CVOs got their existing manuals relating to the functioning of the various departments, PSUs, etc., re-examined to improve the systems with a view to reduce discretions, delays and thus bring transparency and efficiency in the system and to prevent corruption. The Commission has also got the processes in the respective organizations examined incisively to bring about standard operating procedures where they do not exist and to revise the existing ones in tune with the time and other developments. These have brought considerable good results and this is a continuous process. We took one unique initiative of reaching out to students in the schools and colleges in an attempt to make them aware of the need to have a vibrant and corrupt-free India. More than 3 lakh students in over 3,500 schools and colleges across the country in about 140 towns and cities participated enthusiastically in the Vigilance Awareness Week of 2015. While the Commission is encouraging organizations to develop a sound preventive vigilance framework which would enable them to assess the risk of corruption, take steps to correct its policies, procedures and systems, and to strengthen their internal controls to eliminate the scope for corruption, the time has come to address the supply side of the corruption. We find that the private sector is also moving towards introduction of code of conduct for their employees, adopting integrity pact, etc., to ensure a cleaner business environment. Multilateral international organizations have also backed efforts towards tackling the supply side of corruption through anti-bribery conventions. The theme of this year's Vigilance Awareness Week, public participation in promoting integrity and eradicating corruption, was identified in tune with the overall objective of the government of inclusive growth and empowerment of the common man. The Commission believes that an aware, active, involved, empowered public is essential to any anti-corruption campaign. People have to be made aware not only of their responsibility to fight corruption, but also the mechanisms in place to fight corruption. Gandhiji said, "Be the agent of the change that you wish to see in the world." The change cannot be expected to come overnight, and we need to convince the people, especially the youth, that they are the change agents and they have the power to say no to corruption. During Vigilance Awareness Week 2016, apart from activities organized in the government and PSUs for sensitizing their employees and stakeholders, taking pledges, large number of outreach programs were organized through public sector banks, public sector enterprises and government agencies. In particular, at public places such as railway stations, bank branches, petrol pumps, post offices, etc. These include display of hoardings, banners, posters, organizing of grievance redressal mechanism, camps for citizens, and organizing debates, essay writing, drawing of cartoons, painting competitions, dramas, nukkad nataks, puppet shows, panel discussions on vigilance related issues, walkathons, etc. Large number of children of about 16,000 schools and colleges across the country in 831 places, including towns, cities and rural areas, participated in this campaign. To consistently engage the children on the issue of corruption, we have initiated dialogue with the Ministry of Human Resources Development for evaluating and suggesting changes in the existing content on integrity and ethics in the textbooks. Empowered and aware children will surely transform India and make it corruption free. Sir, this year the Commission organized for the first time about 70,000 awareness Gram Sabhas for bringing awareness in rural and semi-urban areas to sensitize citizens on the adverse effects of corruption. The public sector banks, regional rural banks, PSUs and some of the government departments took active interest in such work in reaching out to the public at large. Mahatma Gandhi has said, "The human voice can never reach the distance that is covered by the still small voice of the conscience." The time has come, sir, to appeal to the conscience of every individual so that each may stand firm in their resolve to uphold the high standards of honesty and integrity at all times and support the fight against corruption. The Commission has devised pledges for citizens and corporates and have requested the public to voluntarily take such pledges through the website of the Commission at pledge.cvc.nic.in or by signing a register to record the fact of their taking the pledge in a register to be maintained by the Chief Vigilance Officer. Sir, I am happy to say that the response is quite encouraging. Sir, the Commission has also initiated a project to design a corruption perception index for various government departments and PSUs. To start with, 25 such departments have been shortlisted for carrying out this exercise. Sir, the Transparency International, a Berlin-based NGO, has ranked India at 95 out of 183 in 2011, 94 out of 176 in 2012, and 94 out of 177 in 2013, and 85 out of 175 in 2014. In the year 2015, the latest available, we are listed at 76 out of 175 in the Corruption Perception Index. People at large, from time to time, keep asking very embarrassing questions as to why the India's ranking is so low in the Corruption Perception Index and what is the Commission and the government doing about it. Sir, we all know that in any corrupt practice, in addition to the public authority concerned, some citizen, some organization is also involved. While the Commission continues its efforts to bring a change in the mindset of the public authorities, make all efforts to detect and punish the officers who commit misconduct, this alone will not have the desired effect of eradicating corruption. Unless the public at large resolve not to be a part of any corrupt practice or bribery, etc. It is with this view that the Commission has decided to engage with the public to bring awareness on what constitutes corruption, why they should stay away from corruption, how to make a safe and actionable complaint, and to whom, and also request them to be a part of a movement to take a pledge on behalf of each one of them to be honest and to stay away from corrupt practices. Sir, I once again thank the Honorable Prime Minister and all of you for your kind participation, and I request each one of you to, in your own way, propagate the theme of anti-corruption and the need for integrity. Thank you very much.